Hello and welcome. This is a tutorial on the new features of Proxmox VE 5.3. I am William, a computerized voice, and I will guide you through this video. The new version 5.3 is based on Debian 9.6 and a Linux kernel 4.15. For this version, we have improved storage management on several places. Creating additional local storage can now be done with a few clicks on the disk's management. To demonstrate, let's create a ZFS RAID 10. Choose a name for the storage. Set the RAID level. And select the physical local disks. Then create the storage. Ready to use in seconds. If you cannot use ZFS because you do have a hardware RAID controller or you don't have enough RAM, you can configure traditional LVM or LVMthin. Also, you can use plain extended 4 or the XFS file system for your Proxmox VE storage. To create a LVMthin pool, select the physical disk. Most often this is a hardware RAID volume. Then enter a name for this LVMthin storage. That's it, ready to use. You can now create a directory-based storage in the GUI. Select the physical disk, choose the preferred file system, for example extended 4 or XFS. Enter a name, and ready to go. Now you can see all the newly configured storage types. Go to the Data Center view and click the Storage tab. If you are already using a hyperconverged Ceph storage cluster, you can now add the CephFS file system. Please note that if you run a small hyperconverged Ceph cluster, you need to make sure that you have fast SSDs and enough physical RAM for this workload. In order to enable CephFS, first of all I need to create at least one Ceph metadata servers, as we want high availability here. We will create a metadata server on all of the three hosts. Next, we're ready to create the CephFS, together with the storage definition. That's it, ready to use. CephFS can be used to store backups, ISO images or container templates. The existing ZFS over iSCSI storage plugin is now able to connect to Linux I/O iSCSI provider. So Linux with ZFS can be used on the storage server. We simplified the setup of the virtual GPU and PCI passthrough by adding the configuration to the VM hardware tab. This Proxmox VE host is using an Intel HD 530 graphics, so I can pass through a virtual GPU into my Windows VM. This way I'll get a nice graphic performance inside my VM. As a side note, PCI passthrough and virtual GPU highly depends on the capabilities of your used hardware. Do not expect that this will work with any hardware. Expert use only. On top of these new features, countless bug fixes and small improvements are implemented on several places. The local cursor in NoVNC can be enabled and disabled, and auto-resizing can be configured. With Proxmox VE 5.3 you can now set the memory used for virtual graphic cards. This enables UHD resolution for SPICE. LXC containers can do nesting now. This allows running LXC or LXD inside a container. Also, the use of app armor inside containers is possible. NFS and CIFS can be mounted inside a container. In the case you need to change the main IP of your host, you can edit it via the GUI with /etc/hosts. The new version Proxmox VE 5.3 is available in all of our repositories. Just download the ISO and discover all new features. Thanks for watching, and enjoy working with Proxmox VE.